हेलो, यू हियर मी?
यस सर,
यस सर।
ओके, एक्चुअली वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट दिस एएलयू। Then the last bullet point that when you have the multiple ALUs, then only that microprocessors can do parallel processing. That is important point. That when microprocessor, at least by one microprocessor should have one ALU. Without having ALU, that microprocessor cannot execute instructions. Then microprocessor needs this one. Then, it can do the another work, another parallel operation. The microprocessor is having multiple ALUs. At least that it can have the two ALUs. Then it can do two jobs separately at the same time. Then for the parallel processing, the true parallel processing is not multitasking. For the parallel processing, the microprocessors need multiple ALUs. Otherwise, that it cannot do the different jobs at the same time. Okay. Then timing and control you need. I think this one is doing most important job in the microprocessor. Generally, that to understand that why do we need this timing and control unit?
Mr.
Yes. Hello. Hello. मल्टीपल एलियस මේ ඇති වෙන පටන් ගන්නවා. ඒකට මේ මල්ටිකෝ මයික්‍රොප්‍රොසෙසර් වල ගොඩක් කලින් මල්ටිපෝ ගොඩක් මයික්‍රොප්‍රොසෙසර් ගොඩක් කලින් දැන් Pentium 4 වගේ එනකොට එයා ඇතුලේ ALU කීපයක් තියෙනවා සමහර වර්ෂන්ස් වල. එතකොට දැන් ඒ එතකොටත් මල්ටිකෝ නැහැ, සිංගල් කෝ තියෙනවා. ඒතර සිංගල් කෝ එකක් ඇතුලේ ALU කීපයක් තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. ඒතර මල්ටිපල් කෝස් ආවට පස්සේ හැම කෝ එකක් ඇතුලේ මේ ALU කීපයක් තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. මොකද මේ හැම කෝ එකකටම කේපබිලිටි එක තියෙනවා parallel processing කරන්න. Hello.
Okay, sir.
Now, here that we can, we have to have some kind of idea about that, some other processes of the computer, microprocessor. Then, when you come to this, the second bullet point, control unit execute instructions and generates all necessary control signals according to its proper timing. Then, here that we have summarized that all the function of the control unit using single sentence. Then, actually, that you can see that when we talk about the microprocessor-based systems, you can go to the this one. Here. Now we have this diagram in our mind all the time. Now this is memory. And inside this memory, we have our programs. And this may be our program. And inside the program, we have these instructions. These are instructions. And here we have a pathway from microprocessor to memory to take one of these instructions at a time. Okay. Could you kindly give me another 5 minutes?
Sir, we cannot see the diagram. Okay, sir.
Okay, then we have to take this instruction. Here we have one instruction, and we have to take this instruction to the microprocessor. Then here microprocessor, here inside the microprocessor we have a special place to put this instruction here. Then that part, that module will determine the type of instruction, whether it's arithmetic instruction or maybe logical instruction or maybe the data movement instruction, whatever the type, it will be determined. Okay, then after that microprocessor will start the work according to the instruction received. But this one should be done. You can see that here we have program, and inside the program we have instructions, and we have take instruction along this path. It may be data bus address bus combination. Then we can take that instruction through this path, and we'll put that instruction inside the, this is called this instruction decoder. This container is named as instruction decoder, is actual register, and we put this instruction decoder register will determine the type of instruction and will start the work accordingly, the instruction received. And that's the simple thing we are going to explain. And to do this, and here we have a maybe little bit, and this is our microprocessor, and here we have our ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, and here we have control unit, timing and control unit. This is timing and control unit, and here we have register bank. This is register bank, and along the path microprocessor will be received this instruction, and it take this instruction, and here we have special register called instruction decoder. This instruction decoder will receive the instruction first, then here this is the instruction received, and it will determine the type of instruction, whether it's a arithmetic and logic instruction, it will be sent to this one, this unit, or whether it's a data movement instruction, the microprocessor will act accordingly. But here we have problem now, that how can we execute this instruction? Actually, what is execution of an instruction? How microprocessor can do this, and how microprocessor can identify the type of instruction? It may be simply we can answer the question, the instruction decoder will determine the type of instruction. Now it's okay, the instruction decoder will determine the instruction. Now it will determine. Now after identifying that instruction, what microprocessor has to do? How microprocessor can execute it? Actually, what is the simple meaning of execution? It's simply we can say, identify the type of instruction and generate necessary control signals with proper timing. We can look at it again. Identifying the instruction. Now we have to identify the instruction. It may be data movement instruction, it may be arithmetic instruction, it may be logical instruction, whatever the type of instruction, first microprocessor has to identify the instruction. The determine, we say it's a, the technical word is decoding. Instruction has to be decoded. After decoding the instruction, then only microprocessor knows what to do. Okay. Then, okay, assume that microprocessor has determined the instruction type. It may be arithmetic instruction. Then what microprocessor has to do? Send that instruction to the arithmetic and logic unit. How microprocessor can send this one to the arithmetic and logic unit? Now, there are a lot of pathways. There are a lot of pathways. Maybe inside this one, here to here, and maybe here to here, and maybe here to here, like that. So many pathways are there. then to stop going other devices, there may be some kind of gates here, some kind of locks here. Then when you lock this one, the signals are not going from this point to this one. When you put this lock on, and this signal will not go to the timing and control unit. If you put this lock on, the signal will not go to the register bank. Likewise, that there are a lot of pathways inside the microprocessor to go to different modules, to connect different modules. And at the same time, those paths can be locked that according to our requirement. Microprocessor wants to send some signal to control unit to arithmetic and logic unit, then microprocessor should be able to find that pathway. And when microprocessor is sending the signal to the control unit to ALU, all other pathways should be blocked. Why? Otherwise, the same type of signal will be received by the other modules also. That is a problem. Then we have to stop sending, stop receiving signals by unnecessary modules, and we want to send this signal to the particular modules also. To do that, what we have to do, simply we have to think that, for example, assume that we have a module like this, and we have a module like this, and we have a module like this. This is module 0, this is module 1, this is module 2. And this may be different module. We assume that this is control unit. This control unit has this path. And here. And another module may be there. It also can connect to this. Okay. Then if control unit sends some signal to the different one, this may be register, we say it's R1. Want to send some particular signal to the particular module, there should be a way to do that. But if control unit send this signal out, all these M0, M1, M2, R1 modules will be received the same signal. But it has to be stopped. How can we stop it? Then, to stop that one, there should be a mechanism here. There should be a lock here. Okay. Then there is a lock. How can we control the lock? Okay. Now you can realize another set of wires, another set of devices should be there to control those locks. Then you can see the green color wires are the wires, the pathways to the different each and every module. This is black color things are the locks. To open the pathway to control unit to M1, okay, this may be L1, this is L2, this is L3, and this is L4. To make a pathway from control unit to M1 module, what we have to do? We have to lock L1, we have to lock L3, we have to lock L4, and we have to open L2. Then from this end, we should be able to do that one. Then what are those signals? Control signals. Then if you want to send this some kind of instruction from this instruction decoder to ALU, and now you can realize that some of the locks should be open, some of the lock should be closed. Then how can we do this closing and opening things? Using control signals. Then you can realize that up to a certain extent, now you can guess the meaning of this one. The execution of an instruction is, after identifying the instruction, it has to generate certain control signals with proper timing to reach that particular instruction to the necessary module. Okay. Then I'll stop sharing this screen and we can go to our slide set again. This one. You can see the second bullet point. Control unit execute instructions and generate all necessary control signals accordingly with proper time. Simple idea is this. It has to generate control signals, but it can generate control signals whatever the way, but it should not be done like that. It has to generate these control signals according to the instructions with proper timing. What do you mean by the proper timing? So sometimes that one instruction should be go to the first unit, and after later on it has to go to the first unit to the second unit. Then the first control signal generate should be generated first. The second control signal generated should be generated after certain time period gone. That's why we are saying that generating of control signals can be done, but it's important to do the smooth functionality. We have to generate these control signals with proper timing. Otherwise, that these instructions will not go to the correct places, and these instructions will not go to the relevant places. That whatever the way we want to do, then instruction execution means that what control unit does is it will generate this all necessary control signals. Why? In order to send this instruction in proper manner. That's what the second bullet point says. But if you did you understand something, and do you have any question? Now it's open. Let's open the floor to you. You can ask questions. Again, come to the first bullet point. The entire operation of the microprocessor is managed by the control unit. ALU is there, register bank is there.
Yes, sir. Mainly the control unit, it will fetch the instruction, then decode it and sending it to the ALU for the processing, right? Execution. So here in the second point, we have given control unit execute the instructions and generate all the control signals accordingly with the proper.
Yeah, actually that the sending the signals to the ALU is again generating control signals with proper timing, because that to send any kind of instruction to the ALU, it has to generate control signals, but it has to generate control signals with proper timing.
So can't hear you properly.
Is it okay now? Is some kind of the signal lacking or something like that? Is a coming intermittently? Is it okay now?
Yeah, there's a signal dropping, sir. So not like early day. Yes, now today a little bit the signal.
Yeah, it may be happened because that I told you that at the other end that inauguration ceremony is going on. I saw that maybe the more than 400 participants are there. Because of that, this heavy workload, heavy the traffic problem, it may be there may be some kind of signal droppings. Now, is it okay? Still no. But I can hear you properly, but I don't know that from my side.
Oh, it's okay, sir.
I can hear, sir.
Okay. Sometimes it might come again. Okay, now the simple idea is that ALU and others can
work. Sometimes, not always.
We have to discuss this one again and again in the, maybe another couple of times also. But this control unit will do that marvelous job, but it has to do everything inside the computer, inside the microprocessor, and it controls everything. But in simple word, but it doesn't matter that don't think too much about this one. The simple task of control unit is it has to identify the instruction and generate all necessary control signals with proper timing. Then you can come to the third bullet point. It performs fetching and execution of instructions. Again, this is not another thing. The same thing we are telling using another set of words. If you go to the second bullet point, the execution of instruction and generate all the control signals with proper timing means is again telling this fetching and execution. What is this fetching and execution of instruction? Can you go back to this hour? This one. Actually, when you come here, this taking instruction and putting it here in instruction decoder, this is fetching. And here, after coming here, it has to do something inside the microprocessor. This is execution. Then the instruction completion is it comprises of fetching plus execution. Now this is complete instruction first. We have to take the instruction. That is fetching. After that, we have to identify the type of instruction and do the necessary operations inside the microprocessor. That is execution. Okay. Then when you consider the one complete instruction execution cycle, it contains this fetching part and execution part. Without taking instruction, we cannot execute. Okay. After fetching also, we cannot do anything without doing execution. Then both parts should be there. We have to bring it and we have to do it. Bring it, do it. Bring it, do it. Then fetch it, execute it. Fetch it, execute it. Likewise, that we have to do this one. And we'll come back to this one in another time, maybe in a couple of minutes time again, in different meanings, in different, using different set of words. But again, we can go back to the previous slide. There. It performs fetching and execution of instruction, the same thing. The last bullet point, after execution, it manages storing results, controlling sir, other devices, etc. Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Yes. Hello?
Yeah. Excuse me. Sir. Now, when you consider about the microprocessor, so we have discussed three main units, ALU, CU, and the register bank. Okay, sir?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes. Then, sir, when we fetch instructions, so from the memory, we are sending the data. Okay. So when we send the data, it will directly go to the control memory register somewhere and sending it to the control unit. So that means that is the fetching part. Then it has to decode. Right, sir? Can you hear me, sir?
Yes. I can hear you. Go ahead.
So can you hear me? Yeah. Then it will be decoded inside the control unit. Then do the necessary execution. So the execution part also done inside the control unit, right? Only the mathematical part is going to the ALU, is there?
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Can you hear me properly?
Hello, sir.
I tried to connect.
Yes, we can hear you, sir.
Okay, I tried to connect using a different line, but it may be.
Yes, sir, we can hear you properly.
But in my case,
yes, sir.
Okay, I think the last time when I hear you that you are asking some kind of question. Can you repeat it again? Sorry. That I am connecting using a different line, but shall we try that one?
Yes, sir. No. Okay, sir. Now you can hear me, sir.
Yeah, up to certain level, I can hear you.
Yeah, can you hear me, sir?
Yeah. You can continue.
Yes. Okay. So when you enter some data, now think you have input 5 plus 6 or something.
Yeah.
So when we fetch that, what will happen? The CPU, the CU, control unit, taking that data and the operation. Then it will execute inside that, right? Yeah. Is that, or it will divide that thing into data and the operation, then finally giving some instruction set and decoding and executing somewhere?
No, actually, Sumedha, that it is doing something differently, but that now at the moment that I didn't explain it.
Or the whole operation executing inside the CU?
Not like that, but some of these things that will be done by control unit, but other parts will be done by the ALU. For example, that the example you have taken here, that addition of two numbers there, that first microprocessor has to go there to the memory, then it will take one instruction there. After identifying it, it's addition instruction, then that we are going to add two numbers together. Okay. Then microprocessor has to, after decoding the instruction, it will identify the instruction is an addition instruction. Then it will send that instruction to the ALU. Okay. Then what is next is that then after the instruction, the data value should be there. Then microprocessor has again come to the memory to take the data value. The number 5 or 6 or something, the number, it has to come to the. Now, first time microprocessor came to the memory, to bring the instruction there. But after bringing the instruction there, it will identify that it's an addition instruction. After identifying the addition instruction, it will send the instruction to the ALU. But now microprocessor is waiting to receive data. Otherwise that it cannot do some kind of addition operation. Okay. Then it will come back to the memory again to bring the number. Then it will bring the number and directly without putting that one to the instruction decoder, because microprocessor knows that the second value is a data. It's a number. The number should not be decoded. Then without putting into the instruction decoder, it will, because it first it has been identified that first instruction is an addition instruction. Now the second value coming from memory is a data value, number value. Then it will send that number to my ALU. And again, it will come to the memory. Then another number may be there. It will bring that number to the ALU. Then after that, ALU does that addition operation. Okay. Then after that, now you can come to the fourth bullet point. After execution, it manages storing results, controlling other devices, etc. Okay. Now, this is the way it has to do all these things. Now, third bullet point, fetching and execution of instruction. Fetching and execution it has to do, but fetching, microprocessor can do fetching? It has to go to the memory and bring the instruction and put it into the instruction decoder. Then after that, it will identify the type of instruction. Then for the execution of instruction, sometimes it has to go to again to the memory to bring the data there. Sometimes for some instruction, there might not be data. Because to execute all the instruction, we don't need data. some instruction need data, some instruction do not. Then according to the type of instruction, again sometimes that microprocessor has to come to the memory to bring the data there. Then after bringing the data, then it will direct it to those things, to the relevant modules. If it is arithmetic or logical operation, it will be directed to the ALU. Or sometimes if it is a data movement instruction, without taking a support from the ALU, the control unit will handle that instruction execution itself. Only the thing that ALU can do is that arithmetic supporting of doing arithmetic and logical instruction execution. Otherwise, all other operations will be done by control unit. Is it okay?
So then when you consider about the control unit functions,
yeah.
So it will take fetching the instructions, decoding, executing, all the things done by the CU. Some arithmetic operations only ALU is performing, right?
Performing, yeah.
Okay. All the controlling part also going through the control unit.
Control unit.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now we can come to the same thing again in different manner using different set of words. The main purpose of the control unit is, okay, can you go back to the our Word document and well, this is our microprocessor. This is memory. Inside memory, we have instructions, maybe add 5, maybe subtract 3, like that. Those may be the instructions. And here we have instruction decoder, and this is the pathway to bring those things. Okay, then what about the fetching? Cycle the fetching part. First thing, we have to go to the memory and locate the instruction to be fetched. Okay, then and this may be the first part. Okay,
excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
What is ID means?
Instruction decoder.
Okay, thank you.
excuse me sir
yeah
sir fetch kiyala kiyanne memory eke thiyena instruction eka processor ekata gene ekata nemena
ekata thama ebeti fetch cycle e patang ganna එතෙන් යන්න ඕන එක ලොකේට් කරගන්න ඕන අයිඩෙන්ටිෆයි කරගන්න ඕන ඒත් ඉස්සර අරගෙන ආවිල්ලා මෙතන ඉන්ස්ට්‍රක්ෂන් ඩිකෝඩර් එකට දාන්න ඕන. ඒ කම්ප්ලීට් සයිකල් එකට තමයි ෆෙච් සයිකල් එක කියලා Now you can see with that little knowledge we can read these lines and again we can go back to the word document. The main purpose of the control unit is instruction decoding and sequencing. Now here that we have fetching and execution, and here we use the different words and try to simplify the operation into certain steps. The decoding phase. Now we are focusing the second part. Okay, now we are focusing the second part. In the second part, reads the instruction from memory, decodes the instruction and identifies the type of instruction, gets the necessary operands, routes them into the appropriate functional units of execution unit, and issues signals to the execution unit to perform and require routes result to be to the specified destination. Now this one, it tells some additional things and it tells some kind of couple of things mixed together. But this is decoding phase. What is decoding phase? First, read the instruction from memory. That's a part of our fetch cycle, and decodes the instruction and identifies the type of instruction. And decoding is not a part of fetch cycle. But here in the decoding phase, in the decoding phase, we consider all the steps together. Decode the instruction and identify the type of instruction. Get the necessary operands. The previous question asked by Sumedh. That he is asked some kind of that mathematical operation. Then we have to go to the memory again to take data also. That is a taking the data is that gets the necessary operands means taking the data to do the operation and routes them to the appropriate functional unit of the execution unit. Because inside the control unit also there are a lot more execution units. From the outside is a control unit, for us is a control unit is a black box, but inside the control unit there may be lot complicated other modules are there to execute different things for different instructions. Sometimes that even one execution unit may be there, it's a complicated one, but we have that thousands of instruction. For those thousands of instructions, maybe more than 1000 of modules may be there to look after each and every instruction. Then those instructions will do the necessary things, but control unit has to send all the signals to the necessary modules to do the proper operation. But we are not telling that all these things in complicated manner, but simple idea is take the instruction from the memory and put it inside the instruction decoder, identify the type of instruction and send them to the proper execution units, then after execution of the instruction and send the results to the proper places. That's what you have to remember, that's what you have to identify, and this simple operation you can imagine in your mind. It's very clear that we have to go to the memory and bring one instruction there, put it into the inside the container. That container will identify the type of instruction, then according to the type of instruction we have to generate necessary control signals for what? To send those instructions to the proper execution units, proper places to do the operation. Then after doing the operation, after completing the operation, we have to send results to the proper places. Remember the steps I am just explaining, and then recall the sentence I have explained in couple of minutes ago. there what I said to you is that instruction execution is identifying the type of instruction and generate necessary control signals with proper timing. It summarizes everything. Bring in the instruction here and decoding the instruction and send, after identifying the instruction, sending those things to the necessary control units, necessary execution units, and after generating the result, sending those results to the proper places. To do all these things, we have to generate control signals with proper timing. Maybe today I'll share my slide set with you and all the Word documents and other things, and so far
excuse I have... Excuse me, sir. I've got a control unit execution.
Mehemai, samahara execution venne control unit ekak athule samahara execution control unit ekata complete karanna baha udaharanayak widiyata wata mona hari numbers deyak add karanna unoth ehema e part ekak control unit ekata karanna baha ne habai e arunahama data movement instruction ekak awa kiyala hitanna vena mokak hari operational support instruction ekak awa kiyala hitanna e wata vena kaga support ekak othana ne dan register bank ekak register ekak kiyala kiyanne memory ekak ne eyata mokot operation ekak karanna baha eya intelligent manusyek nevey ne register bank doesn't contain any intelligence. It cannot do any operation. It's just containers. But ALU has the ability to do some operations, but here, and we don't use ALUs to do all the operations. ALU can do only arithmetic operations and logic operations. But other than all arithmetic and logical operations, who is going to do everything? Control unit. Then inside the control unit, we have much more large set of execution units, and those execution units are the caretakers of the other instructions. You can see the second slide. Then in the sequencing phase, determine the address of the next instruction to be fetched and load the instruction into the instruction point. Here, decoding phase, bring the instruction to the microprocessor and decode it. And if you need, you can take any other data also and do the operation and send the results to the necessary places. That is decoding. And sequencing phase means determine the next instruction to be fetched and bring it into the microprocessor. That is sequencing and decoding. And before that, we talk about this fetching and execution. But doing whatever the thing, we are explaining and we are understanding the same thing again and again, but using different set of words. But I am telling all these things because a different set of words may be there, different operational steps may be there, but explaining the same thing. Otherwise, that if I tell you that fetching and execution only, when you see that decoding and sequencing phase, you might think that what is this? It's completely different from fetching. No, no, the same thing we are explaining. But understand the process. Whatever the names we can give later, but understand the process. What is the simple process? I'm telling it again. Instructions are there in the memory. You have to go there. You have to locate the instruction in the memory and bring it and put it into the instruction decoder and identify the type of instruction and send the instruction and operands, instruction and data to the relevant, maybe the necessary execution units to do the operation. Then they will generate the results and send the results to the relevant places. That is one cycle. After that, you have to locate the instruction again and bring it to instruction decoder. It continues. That is the cycle.
Sir, now the main thing is like when you are teaching, there are many registers, no? Program counter, memory address register, memory data register, like that. So when we are explaining like the instruction set. So here you are having the instructions add 5 sub 3 like that. So each and everything having a pointer, so that pointer will take into the program counter. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Then from the program counter, it will send one by one instructions to the memory address register or data register or taking the stuff. Now here mainly we have discussed about the instruction decoder.
Yeah.
In your explanation, you have used the instruction decoder.
Yes. Actually, that in my explanation, and whatever the thing that you are
instruction decoder represent all the other registers. So.
No. It's not like that. But whatever the thing that you are telling at the moment, it will come maybe a couple of hours later. But to come to that point, but if I explain all these things, this program counter and the program counter pointing out that instruction and bringing all these things, it might be a little bit complicated. That's why I'm coming in this simple way.
All right. Okay, sir.
Maybe it might be a couple of hours time that we'll come to that point. Sir. That is actually, I have prepared the slides also to explain all the operations, but those slides will maybe 7 or 8 slides later. Later on, you will find
that. All right. Thank you, sir.
Then this fetch cycle is something like that. We have to go to the memory and to be fetched and bring the instruction from the memory and put it into the instruction decode. Execution cycle means identify the type of instruction. Data and and this is the one way of writing this fetch execute cycle, but as Sumedh mentioned, but maybe in the another time we'll do it in meaningful manner, meaningful descriptive manner. But here, that after coming here, then ALU is here and control unit is here and register bank they will combinedly work together to do the operation. And for these steps will be carried out by these three modules working together. Okay, anything? Any question up to this point? just try to understand that what we have come from this huge point, and we are taking this instruction here in a little bit meaning descriptive diagram, maybe this, and we are bringing this instruction here. This is a instruction, and maybe the execution cycle, and it has to do several other steps to complete the operation. Is it okay? So whether this fetch, decode, execute, actually normally that execution cycle contains this decoding part. That we say that the fetch, decode, execute, and fetch, execute, like that we use this word in different manner. But normally that for the instruction complete execute the cycle time, instruction cycle is the complete instruction cycle is. Containing two parts, the fetch cycle and execution cycle. But I'm still not explaining the something and mean much more details because we did discuss about instructions and instruction types and actually how this instruction looks like we didn't discuss those things. That's why I'm carefully taking all the words in a certain manner. But after discussing the instruction and all these things, we can put everything together and we'll come back to this one again. For the moment, that if you are okay with this, that we can go back to our slide set again to discuss a different point here. And you know that inside the microprocessor, control unit is there, and ALU is there, and register bank is there. Still, we didn't discuss about register bank, but we'll come to that one later. But before that, can you see this one? This control unit. We use three methods to make this control unit. Namely, we have these three methods: hardwired, microprogramming, and nano programming. Okay. Then, why I am taking this one? can see this your screen. Here you can see that this word. This microcode. Okay. I take this chance to explain this one. Actually, to cover up this microcode one. Okay. This hardwired control units, actually, from its name, you can guess that all the control units they have developed, they have designed this control unit using gates. Okay. It's hardwired control unit. This a Yes, it's a collection of separate circuits. Yes, sir. For example, if you want to do the AND operation, AND circuit is there. If you want to do the subtraction operation is there. Those things are under. But if you want to do the data movement operation, that part is there. If you want to do the different operation, that part is there, developed by discrete gates. Then what is the advantage of having this one? What is the advantage? High speed. High speed and simple. Simple operation. What is the disadvantage? It's not flexible. If you want to change it, you have to change sometimes that everything. Hardwired control units are having gates, and those, if you want to change the design, if you want to do the operation, and sometimes you have to change the entire design. Why? You have connected all the gates to do the operations. Disadvantages, sir. Not flexible. The change. And different set of circuits are there doing different operations. Sometimes this one, instruction one, this instruction two, this instruction three, This is instruction 4 and for each and every operation, we have separate set of gates.
Yes, sir, we can't see the screen.
But
I think we can see only.
Sir, we can.
Excuse me,
point
sir.
Point one only, sir.
Can you see the Word document? What you are looking, what you are seeing? Which one you are seeing at the moment?
Now it's okay, sir. Now we can see.
I think it's getting some kind of delays maybe there.
Yes, it's a delay, sir.
Hello. It's not like this hardwired control unit. Microprogramming control units are is a kind of control units. And likewise, lot of instructions are there inside the microprocessor. And for this instruction part, this instruction and whatever the procedure microprocessor has to do is mentioned in a small program. It's a program. This program related to instruction one. Okay. And here we have some kind of instructions. And when microprocessor wants to execute instruction one, it will come here, and this part of the control unit will be directed to this one, this program segment, and this program segment will be executed to run this instruction one. And these instructions and this is not available to the normal ordinary user. And this, we say this is micro ROM. And these instructions are microcode instructions. Okay. Instead of directly compared to previous one, with previous hardwired control unit, it contains that separate circuit modules for each and every instruction. Then it has to execute this hardwired instruction module to execute the instruction. But in the microprogramming control unit method, that interfacing part is there, but instead of having this hardwired circuit module, we have a small program segment written inside a memory. That part will be executed to execute instruction one. And here the different memory segment may be there. And different set of microcodes may be there. That is relevant to instruction two. Likewise, here we have several set of instructions. What are the advantages? It's flexible. And when you want to change that one, we are not going to change the entire thing. We are actually changing the, not the hardware design. We change the microcode instruction set. What is the disadvantage? Is somewhat slow compared to previous one. The next one is nano programming. Control unit. What can we see here is that same set of things are there, but why do we need this one? instruction 1, instruction 2, end. But here, we have this micro ROM and this for instruction 1, this microcode program is there. But sometimes you can realize that some instructions are general instructions. For example, if you want to add numbers together, for all the addition operations, you cannot have one add instruction, one comment and instruction, you cannot have. Sometimes that you have to add positive to positive number, positive to negative number, and both negative numbers may be there. Sometimes that integer numbers may be there, real numbers may be there, sometimes the decimal fraction, sometimes 14 point numbers may be there. Then one single add instruction cannot do everything. Because of that, here, with this micro ROM method, this microcode has been written to address all the issues, all the varieties, all the options. Because of that, all the time, we have to execute the entire microcode instruction segment. Sometimes it's not necessary because we are going to do only integer operation, only integer addition. Both numbers are integer, we have to do the very simple addition, that's the integer addition. But we have to execute the entire microcode instruction module to do this one. To avoid that one, then it's a time wasting. To avoid that one, then here we have put a different memory. This is instruction 1. This is instruction 2. Here we have small segments for instruction 1, 1. This one, instruction 1, part 2. This is instruction 1, third. And likewise, this instruction 1 and with the relevant instruction comes, it will be automatically selected the relevant instruction part only. And these instructions are, these are, we say this is, these are nano instructions. And these are micro instructions. And these are nano instructions. And we say this is nano ROM. And what are the advantages? High flexibility and faster than micro ROM. Disadvantages. Okay, but remember that these instructions are not available to the programmer. Any kind of developer, this instruction cannot be accessed. This inside the control unit, this micro code instructions or nano code instructions, sometimes we call micro instructions or nano instructions, is not available to us. The manufacturers, they have developed this one and they have done all these parts. It may be nano programming ROM or micro code programming ROM, maybe my control unit may be there. Most probably that these days that we cannot see that hard wired control units, other than very simple micro controllers. Okay, that is all about control units. And these are some examples for this hardwired control units and microprogramming control units and nanoprogramming control units. Some kind of comparison, maybe. Actually, at the moment, we don't have these microprocessors. But these days, when you consider the modern microprocessors, it's a kind of combination. Hardwired control is very hardly found, and these days almost that we don't use that method. Okay, then. Today that I'll share the slide sets, and not only slide sets, that maybe the couple of weeks time that we have written all these in Word documents, and I'll send those Word documents also. And I have email addresses of a couple of you. Then I'll send those things and you can share among other members. Is it okay to have another lecture maybe tomorrow night, Sunday night?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Yeah.
What time, sir?
The Sunday clear door, sir?
We have in the evening.
At 9:30, sir.
At 9 tomorrow, is it okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, 9 after 9. Okay, sir. Okay.
Everyone can participate.
ठीक है अब रोबोटिक आ रही है उस पर
Okay, then if you have any kind of problem that you can call me, otherwise that we can have a lecture tomorrow 9 p.m. Maybe tonight I'll share the video and other things, then you can refer it. Is it okay? Any question? Anything?
Tomorrow or the Monday night?
Tomorrow also is possible. Monday night also possible. If you are okay with that, I can do Monday night also.
I have on Monday, sir.
Sorry?
Monday night.
Sorry, I cannot hear you.
Sir, Monday night is okay. Sorry, sir, we can't hear you. Monday night the evening.
මම හිතුවේ මේ Shamar Inol? Shamar, are you there? Shamar, I remember that Damita Sagar or something on there. So is your bachelor? I think that this will not be because that some of you are telling Monday and some of you are telling Sunday, that I don't know that which one I have to select. Anyway, that you can have your internal discussion and let me know. Sumedha, can you communicate with others and let me know?
Yes, I'll do that. I think most of the students, they can do in Sunday.
Okay.
So we have I'm to fix it okay. Now, sir. And otherwise, what will happen, it will drag, sir.
Yes, actually, that is the problem that maybe, can you take a couple of minutes that I can, maybe that I can leave now? Maybe that I am open. It's floor is open to you. Maybe I'll come back in a couple of minutes time. Then after having your internal discussion, that can you tell me? Let me know that. Otherwise, that as Sumedha mentioned, that if we not decide now, we'll not have this one either Monday or Sunday. Okay, it's up to you. That maybe I'll come back in a couple of minutes. I keep it open.
Yes, sir.
Sumedha, can you take the lead and okay. Have a discussion?
Thank you. Okay. Yeah, lead on. Hey, monada Sunday. Godak katire puluvan ne.
Anybody having problem with Sunday?
Sunday, I think two or yeah. Two or three members can't do on Sunday. So we'll record this thing.
හෙලෝ සන්ඩේස් හොඳයි හොඳයි කියලා මට හිතෙන්නේ සුමේද
ඔව් ඔව් සන්ඩේ හොඳයි ඔහොම දාමු
සන්ඩේ
අපි දෙන්න තුන්දෙනෙක් තමයි මම හිතන්නේ බැරි සන්ඩේ
අපි පුළුවන් නම් මන්ඩේ
ගම් මන්ඩේ
කරලා ගත්තත් කමන්නේ ඔය එක තමයි නැත්තම් මේක ඉවර කරගන්න වෙන්නේ නැහනේ
ඔව් ගැටලුවක් නැහැ අපි මත්තම්
පුළුවන් කියමු සර්ට එතකොට සර්ට
සර්ට සෙපරේට් ලෙක්චර් දෙකක් දාන්න කියමු එහෙනම්
ඕ ඒක තමයි. එතකොට දැන් ඔය කන්ෆියුෂන් ගන්නනේ මන්ඩේ එන්න බැරිය සන්ඩේ නෝ සන්ඩේ එන්න බැරිය මන්ඩේ නෝ දෙකම කොහොම හරි රෙකෝඩින් වලින් දෙක කවර් කරගන්න.
හරි හරි එහෙම
කරගන්න. එතකොට සෑගෙන් අහන්න සන්ඩේ කරන එකද මන්ඩේ කරන්න කියලා එහෙම නැත්ද නැත්නම් ලෙක්චර් දෙකක්ද කියලා.
ලෙක්චර්ස් දෙකක් කරගමු.
ඔව් දෙකක් කරගත්තම
හොඳයි මොකද දැන් අර කරගමු. අපරාදින් නැත්නම් එකම එකයි රිපීට් කරනකින් තේරුමන්න.
ඔව්.
ඔව්.
මොකද කොහොමවත් දැන් සැටර්ඩේ තෙන්න බැරියයි ඉන්නවනේ. එයාලත් ඉතින් කොහොම හරි රෙකෝඩින්
එක ගන්නවා. එකක් කරමු දෙකක් කරමු. එකම රිපීට්
කරමු. මේ සතිය ලිකක් ලෙක්චර් එකක් ලබන සතිය එකක් දාමුද? මේ ලෙක්
එහෙනම්
එක ලෙක්චර්ස් දාමුද?
ඔව් කවපුත් නැහැ. එහෙමත් ගැටලුවක් නැහැ. දැන් එහෙමනම් සන්ඩේ කරනවා නම් සන්ඩේ එක ලෙක්චර් එකයි මන්ඩේ එක ලෙක්චර් එකයි
ඔව් මොකද ලෙක්චර්ස් දෙක දැන්න දාගන්න එක හොඳයි. දැන් මේ වෙලාවේ කර්ෆියු තියෙන හින්දා ප්‍රශ්න තියෙන හින්දා ගොඩක් වෙලාවට ගොඩක් කට්ටිය ෆ්‍රී ඉන්නවා.
ඔව් ඉන්නවනේ.
ඒකත් දැන් මොකද අපි දන්නේ නැහැ ඊළඟ සතිය වෙද්දි මොන වගේ සිටුේෂන් එකක් එයිද කියලා. අපි ඒකින්ද ළඟ තියෙන දවස් දෙකම දාගන්න.
සමහර කට්ටිය අර shift තියෙන ඔපෝට් එක. ඔව් මේ මෙහෙමයිනේ මේක ඔන්ලයින් නේ කොහොමද?
ඕනේ අපි දැන් සර්ට මොන වගේ සිටුේෂන් එකක් එක්ක දාන්නේ මොන් කියන්නේ අපිට නෙමෙයි අපිට රෙකෝඩින්ග් ඔන්ලයින් කොහොමද තහන්
කරන්නේ වැඩරනේ
රාක්නේ බේසිකලි කියන්නේ එතකොට සල්ස
පුළුවන්
නේද
ආ ඒක උඩ පුළුවන් ආකාරයකම අපි වැඩිම බල ගන්න ඒක අනිවාර්යෙන් ඉස්සෙකේ සුමේද සුමේද ඔය කන්ෆර්ම් කරන්න සන්ඩේ මන්ඩේ දෙකම
දවස් කරනවා දෙකම දවස් හරි හරි මම එහෙම කියන්න
ලෙක්චර් දෙකක් දාන්න කියන්නේ සුමේද වෙනම දෙක වෙන ලෙක්චර් දෙකක්
වෙන වෙන
එහෙම කරමු එහෙම කරමු
ඔව් එතකොට ඒක රෙකෝඩින් එකක් අපිට බලා ගන්න පුළුවන් නේ අපිට
yes ඔව් ඒක තමයි හොඳම මම එහෙම කියන්නම් මේ සෙපරේට් ලෙක්චර්ස් දෙකක් දාලා
දෙන්න ඔව් අපර කට් ඔව් නමේ දාන්න කියන්නේ නමේ දවස් දෙකේ නමේ දාන්න
කියන්නේ 9 to 11 දාගමු
ඔව් එහෙම හොඳයි නේ
මේ දෙක ලෙක්චර්ස් දෙකම එක වෙලාවටද
ඔව්
එක වෙලාවට
9 දාමු ඔව් මන්ඩේ 9 දාමු සන්ඩේ 9 දාමු
ඔව් ගැටලුවක් නැහැ
අපි කොළඹ විදියට ඉවර කරගත්තා නම්
මන්ඩේ එක රෑ නේද රෑ නේද
රෑ රෑ
රෑ රෑ රෑ
ඔව් රෑට නේ 9 කියන රෑ
අපි මේ යන විදියට ලෙක්චර්ස් එක ඉවර කරගත්තා නම් හොඳයි නේද
හොඳම දේ එක තමයි පුළුවන් ඉක්මනට ඉවර කරගන්න එක.
රටේ සිටුේෂන් එක දැන් බෑඩ් නේ ඉන්නේ.
ඔව්.
එහෙනම් සුමද කන්ෆර්ම් කරනවා. ඒක හරි. ඔකේ.
हेलो
हेलो सर
आप ही पता सिर्फ पहाड़ के क्या नहीं हेटर नहीं हेटर नहीं
हेटाई अनिद्दा इधर क्या मैं सर ये पुलवान ना हेटे
पुला पुला मट पुला
आप ही मैं कंफर्म कर रहा हूँ सर मैं 9 पीएम अभी शेड्यूल कर रहा हूँ ये तो कड़ा
हाय हाय
अभी शेड्यूल
इन्हें कमाने तो अपने सेशन दे आती आगे पुलवान नहीं तो करें
චතුරු සර් නිකන් ඉන්ෆෝම් කරුවා නේ හරියට අපිට ලින්ක් එක ෆෝවර්ඩ් කරයිනේ ඔක්කොලන්ටම ලින්ක් එක එනවා නේ සර් එතකොට
එනවා නේ ඔව් හරි මම සර්ට කතා කරන්න
හරි සර් රයිට් thank you very much sir
හරි thank you සුනිද
ඔකේ සර්